The word THE in Greek is God. And so we get our word the. And so the emphasizes something important. We have facts, but then this is the fact. And so the is in something important because in Greek, the, T-H-E, is God. So that's why we have churches, which we call a theater. It's like a movie house. It's a big theater. Everyone comes in, pays whatever they can, and they sit and watch a show. And it's a theater. It's the it's a God show. And so they're putting on the God show, and they light candles and sing hymns, and it makes people feel very holy and feel good about themselves, and they're there with their friends and their neighbors. And so it's kind of like a fraternal order. It's kind of like a Masonic order or a club in which everyone is there to encourage each other, and they all feel good about each other's company. But nobody, including the priests and the clergy, actually know where these words have come from, why we have candles in a service, and the connection between candles on an altar and an erection in sex. Is people have no idea where the concept of the candle came from. And they have no idea what the ritual singing of hymns has to do with mind control. And the frequencies of mind control, and why churches are built on the particular way they are built, with the steeples. And steeples represent, according to dictionaries and encyclopedias, will tell you that church steeples represent a male phallic. How many people know that? So the point I'm making is the entire superstructure of what we call the religious world, be it Christian or Jewish or Hindu, all has to do with the phenomenally basic world we live in. Sex, the stars, money and corruption, control and government is all a mess. And it's all designed for the picking of the people for what they want. They know not everybody is going to be a Jew. Not everybody is going to want to be a Catholic. Not everybody is going to want to be a Mohammedan. Not everybody's going to want to be what everybody else is. So they have to provide the human family with all kinds of alternatives and ideas. And some people don't like this and that. That sounds like Jehovah's Witnesses. So people would join the Jehovah's Witnesses. Some people don't like this and that about the government. Well, that sounds like Seventh-day Adventists. So they got a church to go to, Seventh-day Adventists. And then they found out that, no, this and that's wrong, so we don't like this and that. Well, that sounds like the Church of God in Pasadena. And so when you're through with this, at the end of the period of time, for 2,000 years, we have all kinds of religions. I once read it was like 2,400 so-called Christian religions and cults around the world. 2,400. Different Christian churches and ideas around the world. And God knows how many Jewish groups there are. There's all kinds of Jewish groups, and all of them seem to hate each other. And there's Muslim groups who hate each other. And all the different religious groups, they all hate each other. It's a monstrosity of ignorance that the human race is involved in. And unfortunately, I don't think we're going to be able to extricate ourselves out of this mess, because wisdom and knowledge is the only thing that's going to help you. And the people have no knowledge. Even the scripture says, my people are dying from a lack of knowledge. They haven't got the faintest idea in the world what is really going on the earth that they live on. So that's what I'm trying to do, is just wake people up to the fact that you're not intellectually honest and you really don't know what's going on. And you really actually should go back to school and learn how to read. And if you can read, then put down the magazines and the Paris Hilton stories in your local supermarket and start reading the encyclopedias and dictionaries and go to a library. My God, you still today have a world of knowledge out there on the web. All the encyclopedias of the world are on the web. The dictionaries of the world are all there in every language. And the people are more ignorant today than they've ever been. So that tells me that most of the web is being used for entertainment, and almost nothing out there is being used to educate the human mind. And what makes it even worse is that the government of the United States does not want you to know what's going on. The government is so corrupt today, it does not want you to understand anything. That's why they make damn sure that you have a liquor store on every corner in every city, period. So they can make liquor available to everybody. And they make it cheap enough so that they will be out, you, no matter who you are, they will always have a drink for you to keep you intoxicated. They always have the titillating stories about sex and drugs and mafiosis and gangsters with movies. They, the system wants to make sure that you are continually occupied drinking alcohol, shooting drugs, selling drugs, involved in corruption, anything to keep you busy so you don't look at really who owns you.